हेलो, आर यू
यस
गाइस एबल टू
सर।
हियर? ओके ओके, सो वी विल गेट स्टार्टेड। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड प्रोबेबिलिटी, राइट? सो टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग द लास्ट चैप्टर, विल बी स्टार्टिंग द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर 11th सिलेबस, दैट इज स्टैटिस्टिक्स 15th चैप्टर। देयर इज अनदर चैप्टर व्हिच इज कॉल्ड मैथमेटिकल रीजनिंग, बट दैट इज रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम योर सिलेबस। सो वी विल बी डूइंग statistics and that will be the end of the syllabus. Okay, now coming to statistics, there's not a new term, you have learned it last year as well, right? So it mainly speaks about a concept called as central tendency. So what does central tendency mean? What are the three variables that come under the central tendency?
Mean, median, and mode.
Yes. We talk about mean, median, and mode. Let's try to. So, in this chapter, right, in your 11th standard, the central tendencies that we are going to concentrate upon are the mean and the median. We will not be concentrating upon mode. So, since you people have already learned, we will just see the outline, then we will go into the other concepts. So, what does mean? What is the meaning of the term mean?
The average of all the numbers.
Yes. So you take the average of all the numbers, then we call it as mean. What is the basic formula of average of all the numbers? If suppose, let's say you have 20 students in your class, if I ask what is the average, the class average for physics test in this particular, for the physics test in this particular exam. So what is going to be the average mark? How do you calculate the average? Sum of all numbers divided by the total number, all right, or total students. All right, so this is how you take the average for what kind of a data, all right? So before I speak about central tendency, that is mean and median, the most important thing we are supposed to concentrate upon is called as data, right? So you are going to calculate the mean or median for a set of data that is given to you. For example, in the concept we spoke previously, I tried to calculate the sum of the average of all marks. Means the data that is given to me is mark of individual students for a particular exam, and they gave me the total number of students who have written the exam. So I calculated the sum of all those things and divided with 10. Maybe that has happened because the number of data I have in my hand is less. Sometimes the data will be given in some other format also. What are the other format that you people know? I'm just trying to find out how much you people know. What are the other form in which the data will be given to you guys? Before that, the marks are given to you, right? The 20 individual marks that are given to you, what is the name of the particular data? Guys, are you able to understand what I'm asking? If I give you marks student, okay, or else I'll give you like this. Student marks, student 1, student 2, marks are 20, 25, something like this. I give you 20 students, like 22, something like this. Okay. So this is the data that is given to us. The data is in what form? Is it continuous? Is it split? There is a specific name for this kind of a data, right? We call it as dash data. It's called as discrete data. Guys, are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
So if I give you discrete data, as you told, the average is calculated by sum of all the values divided by the number of data, the number of values that you have in your hand. Right. Similarly, we can think of another type of data, which is called as frequency distribution. So what can happen if the data is wide ranged? Then what can you do? Instead of giving the individual marks, you will give the range of marks. You would have seen this, right? 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. If I give something like this, if I say 5, 6, 3, something like this, then what have I given? There's the range and there's the frequency. So what is the meaning of this, guys? What kind of a table is this? Do you guys know this or not?
Frequency table.
It's called frequency distribution table, right? All these things you would have learned in your 10th standard, if I'm not wrong. Right? Now comes. So can I see, with the assumption that you know the basics, can I directly jump into the formulae? In the sense, how to handle discrete data, how to handle cumulative, how to handle frequency distribution table. Okay, let's see, let's go one by one itself. If suppose, if you want to calculate the mean, what is the formula that is used? So how is mean represented? Please make a note of it. So mean of a data is represented with the variable and what on the top of it, a bar on the top of it, or the other way of representing mean is something like this, or we call it as x mean, or we call it as x average. All these things are going to represent the mean, but in mathematics, the state that we are going to use is something like this. So what is the formula for x bar? If suppose I have the data like this, x1, x2, so on till xn. Okay, I want to calculate the average of this. Then how do I calculate? It is sum of all the values, sigma. Okay, in Greek, there are two sigmas. One is this sigma and the other one, this is also a sigma. So we'll be using both in this chapter. So be careful. This sigma is used for sum. The other sigma, we will see it later. So sigma, how do I write it? X is the variable. And the suffixes are varying from 1 to n. Can I call it as xi? Where the I is ranging from where to where?
1 to n.
I is equal to 1 to n. The whole divided by the total number of values that you have in your mind. So this is going to be the formula for average to be calculated for what kind of a data? For discrete data. Discrete data means they are spread out data. That is the meaning of discrete. Right? Shall I proceed to the next concept? If suppose I have 5 values in my hand. I've randomly written, okay? Don't think about the numbers in order. So I've randomly written the data. Okay, I'll take it like this. I'll take it like this in the order. Now, if I ask you to calculate the median, what do you mean by median, guys? Median in terms of central tendency is what? In terms of statistics is what? It is the
middle
term. So median means middle term. So in the numbers 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, which is taken as a middle term?
4.
It is 4. If suppose I have the same data like this, 4, 5, 7 and 10. If I ask you what is the median in this case, what will you see?
4 plus 5 by
2. Just like this. So, why did you say 4 plus 5 by 2? What do you do? Why is it so? How did you find it?
Even number of...
It is because of the even number of terms. So, it is something similar to what we have done in binomial theorem. Okay? Listen. If the number of observations is odd, then the median is given by n plus 1 by 2th term. If the number of observations is even, then the median is what? The median itself is the mean of n by 2th and the n by 2 plus 1th observation. Okay. So in this case, how many numbers are there? 6. So the average of which term? 6 by 2th term plus 6 by 2 plus 1th term divided by 2. So what is 6 by 2th term? That is 3rd term. So 3rd term is 4 plus 6 by 2 plus 1th term. That is 5. The whole divided by 2. How much is this? This 4.5. So this is going to be the median. So this point also you guys know. So I'm not extending much. Okay. The next is, see, the average part is okay. I'll tell you the real-time application of it. See, for example, you guys do an experiment in the lab. Let's say when you do an experiment in the lab, what do you do? What is your main work? So you prepare a tabular column. Right. What do? You calculate the values and make a note of all those observations. Let's say x1, x2, so on. You're saying xn. Okay. When you do an experiment, see, on a real-time basis, when you do an experiment, will you stop it by doing once and take down the data and say that this is the right value? Or are you going to do it multiple times? Are you going to repeat it or not? That's the question I'm asking.
Repeat it, sir.
So you repeat it. Why do we do that? Why can't you stop?
Get an accurate value.
You to get an accurate. How do you say it's an accurate value? Why not the first reading itself is accurate?
There might be an error in it.
Error. Okay. So that error. What do you mean by error, guy? Error. Huh? What do you mean by error? Means, are you trying to say there will be a variation in the first value and the second value?
Is yes.
What you're trying? Yes. Right. So, whenever really on a practical basis, whenever you do something, whenever you take an observation, all the outputs will not come under the come as the same values because any of the parameters might change on a real-time basis. So, if I have two readings, how can I say which? How do I choose which one is right? I don't know which one is going to be right. So, for that to be overcome, what do we do? We take the average of all the values and say, yes, this should be the appropriate value. That's what we are saying. Though we take the average, even that is not going to be the accurate one. But average is what we are assuming it to be the true value. Are you able to understand what is true value? You are trying to say that this is the accurate answer by calculating the average of it, by taking this formula sigma I, where I is equal to 1 to n, the whole divided by n. But you told me, so I'll ask another question. So you are getting an average, right? Is this average going to be, I'm putting a question, listen to it. Is it necessary that this average should be any one of the values in these n readings or it can be anything else also? I'm repeating the question, listen to it carefully. You're getting the true value, right? The average of all those things. Is it necessary that it should be any one of the n values or it can be a value other than that also?
So it can be a value other than that.
Okay. It can be any value. It need not be any one of the values. It can be any value other than that. It need not be in the table at all. Okay. Because that's what we are saying true value because you have repeated the experiment many times. If that is going to be the case, then can I say every value, every individual reading that you have taken is going to have some variation compared to the true value that you are reporting at the final step. So this is an individual reading. This is an individual reading. Like that you have n individual readings in your hand. All those n individual readings are definitely going to have some variation with respect to whom? With respect to the value, the true value that you have reported. Am I right? Are you guys able to understand what I'm trying to say? You want me to give an example and explain? Which is comfortable? You want me to, is the theory part okay, or you want me to give an example and do it?
Could you give one example alone?
Yeah, I'll give you. I'll let's take a simple data. 5.3, 5.15, 5.2. Okay. 1020. So, report your true value up to two decimals. So, I'm asking what is the true value. I've given you five readings. Just tell me what is the answer. No? Tell me what is true value. How much is it? 25.95 divided by 5. How much is that? It is
5.19, sir.
So that is the true value. Is there any value which is 5.19? You're saying your true value is close to the second reading, but it is not exactly equal to the second reading. So this 5.19 is varying from all the individual readings that you have got. Okay. So that all the difference that you speak, in terms of physics, we call it as error. In terms of mathematics, we call it as dispersion. We call it as dispersion because the values are dispersed. There is some variation or difference that is existing. So that's what is called as the measures of dispersion. Guys, am I clear? So the dispersion is also known as scatter in data, is measured on the basis of the observations and the types of the measure of central tendency used there. There are following methods of dispersion. One is called as range, second is quartile deviation, third is mean deviation, and the fourth is standard deviation. So what we are going to concentrate is range, mean deviation, and standard deviation. The standard deviation will be a part of the next exercise. Okay, let's first try to understand what range means. Forget about all the theory. If I give you a data, what does a range mean? What do I mean by range of values? For example, if I ask you, what is the range of data that I've given here? What will you say? (5.10) is the least value that I'm able to find in the table. And what is the maximum value?
5.30.
So 5.30. So the range is going to be the values that are existing between the least and the maximum values. That's what a range means. Okay. So that is one of the methods of measures of dispersion. Suppose I have to talk about mean deviation. Okay. Recall that the deviation of an observation X from a fixed value A is the difference X minus K. So in order to find the dispersion of X from the actual central value A, we find the deviations about A. I'll tell you what it means. Okay. So an absolute measure of dispersion is the mean of all these deviations. Try to understand, guys. Here, they are saying mean deviation. Right. Now I'm preparing a table. See, I'm going to prepare a table. I have observations. Okay. 5.10, 5.20, 5.30, 5.15, 5.20. Then I got the true value as 5.19. If I ask you, what is the deviation of all these values? What are you going to say? If I ask you, what is the deviation of the reading X1 from the true value? If I put a question like this, then what will you say? It will be 5.10 minus 5.19. Does this make sense? So this 5.10 minus 5.19 is the deviation of what? Of the reading number 1 from the so-called true value. And how much is the value coming out as? Minus 0.09. What is the meaning of this? The minus sign indicates that the reading is 0.09, is of a value of 0.09 less than the reading that you have obtained. Correct? Similarly, for the second reading, 5.20 minus 5.19 is going to give me 0.01. Like that, I'll be able to calculate the deviation of all the values. Now, let's try to read what the statement says. Okay. The deviation of an observation x from a fixed value a is the difference x minus a. In order to find the dispersion of x from the central value a, we find the deviations about a. That's what I've done. This is deviations about whom? About true value. Can I state it like this? But here, they are not talking about deviation. Rather, what are they using? They're calling it as mean deviation. So, what is the meaning of it? So, what do you mean by mean deviation?
Sum of all the deviations by
number of deviations divided by the number of observations that you have. Okay. So, what you can do in this problem is, if calculate what is the deviation and calculate the average and tell me what is the value. -5.19 is -0.04 5.20 -5.19 is 0.01. Can you calculate the average without taking the signs into consideration? Say if you observe,
you should not take the sign into consideration, sir.
That is in physics. Here you take. You take, no? For example, take and see, no? What is going to happen?
You get cancelled, sir. It'll be zero.
That's what they're trying to say. See. It will get cancelled. You will get 0.13 minus 0.13, right? In that example. So, to find the mean, we must obtain the sum of the deviations, but we know that the measure of central tendency lies between the maximum and the minimum values of the set of observations. That's why 5.19 lied between what? The value which we got, 5.19, lied between 5.10 and 5.30. It will lie between the minimum and the maximum value. Okay? So, therefore, the sum of the deviations will be negative and sum will be positive. Thus, the sum of deviations may vanish. Moreover, the sum of the deviations from mean x is zero. Are you able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
So they have given it theoretically. We took an example and observed it. That's it. Thus, finding the mean of deviations about mean is not of any use for us as far as the measure of central dispersion is concerned. So, I can talk about deviation from any value. What did I take? In this case, I took the deviation about true value. Might be I can think of a deviation about the median. It's my wish. I will take median into consideration. I will say, how much is each individual reading varying from my median? Maybe that time I'll get a non-zero value. Okay. So by you getting a zero, what are you trying to say? The mean of deviations is zero means you are trying to say that none of the values have deviations. So it is of no use. What is the use of the data for us? Right? So, remembering that in finding the suitable measures of dispersion, we require the distance of each term from the central tendency or a fixed number A. Recall the absolute value of the difference of two numbers gives the distance between the numbers when represented on a number line. So, what we are going to do is now to overcome that process, we are going to take its absolute value. Rohan, as you told, now you will be taking positive value. Now you got your answer why you need to take the positive value into consideration.
Yes, sir.
Yes, got it? So that is where the absolute comes into picture. So the absolute value of the difference of the two numbers gives the distance. Distance means what? It's always a positive value. Distance between the numbers when represented on the number line. Thus, to find the measure of dispersion from a fixed number A, we may take the mean of the absolute values. We don't take the mean of the exact numbers that we have obtained. Means the sign is going to be ignored. Thus, mean deviation about a central value A is the mean of the absolute values of the deviations of the observations from A. Okay, don't forget this word absolute. So what should have been done in the example? You should have taken the average by considering this as positive and this also as positive. You do that, you will get 0.13 plus 0.13 the whole divided by 5. How much are you going to get? 0.26 divided by 5.
0.02.
So this tells you that each reading approximately has a deviation of 0.052 on either of the sides. It can be 0.052 more than the original value or less than the original value. That is on an average. Okay, are you able to understand? Then this value is what is called as mean deviation about what? Mean deviation about the true value. So that is how we represent. MD stands for mean deviation. A is the true value. So mean deviation about point A is equal to the sum of absolute values of deviation from the A divided by the number of observation. Okay. So here there is an important remark. Mean deviation may be obtained from any measure of the central tendency. However, mean deviation from mean and median are commonly used in statistical studies. Let us now learn how to calculate the mean deviation about mean and mean deviation about median for various types of data. Guys, are you able to understand mean deviation? This is one of the measures of dispersion. This will also fail actually. There is a drawback with this also. Due to the drawback of this only, we'll go for a concept called a standard deviation that we will see later. As of now, let's try to understand how to calculate the mean deviation of ungrouped data, that is nothing but a discrete data in your hand. Let n observations be x1, x2, so on till xn. Then the following steps are involved in the calculation of mean deviation about mean or median. See, since we have done this problem, I know, can I directly give you the formula itself?
Yes, sir.
So observations, okay. Deviation about mean deviation about mean. Now observe. So observations are x1, x2, so on till xn. Let's say the average comes out to be, okay, it's not A according to the textbook. Let the average is x bar. That the average is x bar. If I have to calculate the deviation about mean, what am I supposed to do? I will write it as x1 minus x bar. Similarly, here it will be x2 minus x bar. So on till last one will be xn minus x bar. If I have to calculate the mean deviation about mean, what am I supposed to do? Then I need to take the modulus of all these values. That is modulus of xi minus x bar, the whole divided by what? N, where the summation is going to be from 1 to n, is what is called as mean deviation about mean. Am I clear, guys? So if you have to calculate the mean deviation about any data, the formula will be like the sigma I is equal to 1 to n, modulus of xi minus whatever is the value you are going to write here will decide you are calculating the deviation from which value. If you write A, that A might be some individual reading. Okay. Similarly, if you are calculating it from mean, then you have to write mean here. If you are calculating it from median, you have to write median here. Okay. Please make a note of this formula. We'll do some examples so that you can understand. Are you done?
Yes, sir.
Let's see. So the question says, find the mean deviation about mean for the following data. This is a very, very simple question. What are we supposed to do? First, calculate the mean. X bar is equal to sigma xi from I is equal to 1 to n, the whole divided by n. So what is X bar? 6 plus 7, 13, 13 plus 10, 23, 23 plus 12, 35, 35 plus 13, 48, 48 plus 4, 52, 52 plus 8, 60, 60 plus 12, 72 divided by how many data? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You have 8. So the average is 9. But what are they asking? The mean deviation about mean. So I will write down like this. Observations. So what is the observation? 6, 7, 10, 12, 13, 4, 8, 12. Right? So what is the mean deviation from mean, guys? There's 9. The average value is 9. So what do I write here? 6 minus 9, which is minus 3. 7 minus 9, which is minus 2. 10 minus 9, which is 1. 12 minus 9, which is 3. 13 minus 9, which is 4. 4 minus 9, which is minus 5. 8 minus 9, which is minus 1. 12 minus 9 is 3. Correct? So what is the mean deviation? That is? Three plus two plus one plus three plus four plus five plus one plus three. The whole divided by the number of observations, that is 8. So 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 4, 13, 13 plus 5, 18, 18 plus 1, 19, 19, 22 divided by 8. I hope you guys got it.
Yes, sir.
You should write all the formula, okay? So 22 by 8 is 3.75. On an average, each value is varying from the original value by 3.75 units. Okay. Next. Find the mean deviation about the mean for the following data. Only thing is the question is big, but the method is the same. Okay. Let's do the third example. Find the mean deviation about the median. Find the mean deviation about the median for the following data. What are we supposed to do? First, let's try to arrange them in what? Ascending order. So 3, 3, you have 4. Do you have a 5? Yes, 5 is there. 6 not there, 7 is there, 8 is not there, 9 is not there, 10
is there.
11 is there. Sorry?
9 is there, sir. It's the second number.
9 is there, okay, okay. 3, 7, 9, 10. Then 12. So 9, 5, 12, 10, 7 is over. 12,
18, 19, 20.
Okay. So how many readings are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 readings are there. What will be the median? Median will be the sixth term. Because n plus 1 by 2th term. So 11 are there. No, 11 plus 1 by 2. It will be the sixth term. One, two, three, four, five, six. So median will be 9. Now, what is going to be the deviation from median? Three minus nine, 4 minus 9, 5 minus 9, 7 minus 9. 9 minus 9, 10 minus 9, 12 minus 9, 18 minus 9, 19 minus 9, 21 minus 9. Can you tell me, guys? So -6, -6, -5, -4, -2, 0, 1, 3, 9, 10. 12. So how to calculate the mean deviation? So the mean deviation about the median is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n xi minus m divided by the total number of observation. So 6 plus 6, 12, 12 plus 5, 17, 17 plus 4, 21, 21 plus 2, 23, 24, 27, 36, 46, 58. So it is 58 divided by 9. Oh, you have 11 data in your hand. 58 divided by 11. Is it clear, guys? So this is the mean deviation from the median. Guys, am I clear? Is there any confusion?
No, sir.
Okay. So this is how you calculate the mean deviation for ungrouped data. Now we will see for group data and conclude the session. So mean deviation for group data, we know that data can be grouped in two ways. One is discrete frequency distribution and continuous frequency distribution table. Right. So let us discuss the method of finding the mean deviation for both types of data. One is discrete frequency. Discrete frequency means what? You will have one observation. For that one observation, you will speak about the frequency. What do you mean by continuous distribution? What do you mean by continuous distribution, guys? Continuous distribution will have a range of data and you will have the frequency for it. Clear? So now we are going to concentrate on the discrete frequency distribution and we are going to calculate the mean deviation for it. Okay. So let the given set of data consist of n distinct values x1, x2, so on till n occurring with frequencies f1, f2, so on till n respectively. This data can be represented in the tabular form which is given below, which is called as the discrete frequency distribution table. Right. So how will you calculate the mean for this? So how is mean calculated for a frequency distribution table? I'll put it like this: data, frequency. So data x1, x2, so on till xn. Frequency is f1, f2, so on till fn. How do I calculate the mean? See, the previous case, when I wanted to calculate the mean, I could have added all these values and divided with the total number of readings. But here, I cannot do that because x1 is not the exact number of value. Because x1 is obtained by how many people? F1 number of people. Then how do I calculate, guys? Then I'll have a column called xi fi, where I'll multiply x1 into f1, x2 into f2, so on till xn into fn. This will give me the total number of values that are obtained by f1 number of people, right? So x1 into f1 means each person is obtaining x1. So again, let's take it as marks itself. Let's say if I give you a data like this, 25 marks is obtained by 5 students. 20 marks is obtained by 4 students. If I give you something like this, if I ask you to calculate the average of these two, these are the marks, these are the frequency. If I ask you to calculate the average of this, if you calculate it as 45 by 2, that is 22.5, is your answer right?
No, sir.
Why?
Because the frequency is 5 and 7.
Yes, because the 25 is the marks obtained by 5 students. Correct? Then, what is the total number of marks that you have in your hand? It is 25 into 5. It is 125. 20 into 4, that is 80. So the total marks that are there are 125 plus 80. I'm talking about the total marks. This is marked by one of the students into 5 will give me the marks obtained by 5 students. Why we are writing it like this is because we are trying to club it. Instead of writing 25 5 times, I'm writing 25 here and I'm creating a frequency. So what will be the total? 205 divided by how many number of students have actually participated? How many students have participated? 9 students. It is 9. 5 plus 4. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
So 9, no? So 9 means, are you able to understand? 20. How much is the value? Can you tell me? 2, it is 25. 25 means again 22.5 means you'll have 7. 7 is
2.8, I think, sir.
It'll be 72.7 something, 22.7 something. Actual value is 22.7, but here you got it as 22.5. Look at the variation. Which one is right out of these two? It is 22.7 that is right, because why we are actually using this discrete frequency distribution is this thing is the same as this and this are the same. This is discrete data, whereas this is discrete frequency distribution table. If I write the same data in the discrete form, how many lines am I supposed to use? I'm supposed to use 9 lines. Whereas if I convert the same thing into a frequency distribution table, I'm able to finish it in 2 lines. Are you able to understand? They both represent the same. But I'm just trying to tell you why we are using a different format. Guys, does it make sense? Are you able to understand? Right? So that is the reason why we see you calculate the average for this also, you would still get it as 22.7. That will happen because 25 is multiplied with itself 5 times and 20 is multiplied with itself 4 times. When you calculate the total number of marks divided by the total number of people's data that you have in your hand, it is going to give you the answer. Okay, so that's what frequency distribution means. So the same thing, if I write it in a general format, how do I calculate the mean? It is sigma xi into fi, where I is equal to 1 to n, the whole divided by sigma fi, where I is equal to 1 to n. Now, we are able to understand why the formula has actually come out like this. You would have learned this for sure. But I'm not sure if you know the reason of why it is like that. Are you guys clear with this? Can I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, our objective is to calculate the mean deviation about mean. So data, frequency. Okay. I will take an example and explain it better. let me take this example. I don't know why it is coming like this, but wait. Find the mean deviation about mean for the following data. So this is what, there's an example of discrete frequency distribution, correct? So first, if I have to calculate the mean deviation, what is it I need first? I need the mean of it. So for me to obtain the mean, I need another row, xi into fi. What is xi into fi? 4. Forty, 60, 56, 80, and 60. Right? So what is going to be the mean? Mean will be sigma. I'll leave some gap here. So mean will be sigma xi fi, the whole divided by sigma fi, where I is equal to 1 to n. Here also I is equal to 1 to n. So add all these values. 4 plus 40 plus 60 plus 56 plus 80 plus 60. The whole divided by, what is the total number of data that you have in your hand? 2 plus 8, 10, 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 7, 27, 27 plus 8, 35 divided by 40. 40, 4, 40, wait, 100, 150, 230, 230 plus 60, 290, 290 plus 4, 294 divided by 40. That is 29.4 divided by 4. How much is this? 7.12 is 3. 2 comes as a remainder, 0.5. So it is 7.305. This is the average. Right? But what are they expecting us to calculate? They are expecting us to calculate the mean deviation about mean. Now, what do you think will be the formula for mean deviation about mean? So the mean deviation about mean will be calculated like this. Can someone tell me what is going to be the value? I'll tell you the logic to remember, okay? When you have a discrete data, how did you calculate the mean deviation about mean? What was the formula? Sigma I is equal to 1 to n modulus of xi minus x bar, the whole divided by n. Right? You use this because you had discrete data in your hand. If it is discrete frequency, then what am I supposed to do? First, I need to calculate how much is my individual reading varying with respect to the mean. Right? So I need a column of xi minus x bar. So what does xi minus x bar tell me? 2 minus 7.305 minus 5.305. 5 minus 7.305 minus 2.305. 6 minus 7.305 minus 1.305. Let me check if the calculation is right. Wait. Is there a mistake in the numbers that you have taken? It's coming out as 300, but I got 290. 294. Is there anything wrong, guys? Oh, this is 56, sir. Sorry. So I need to add a 6 to this. That is 300. So 300 by 40. Is it clear till this step? So you guys tell me what is going to be xi minus x bar. Means how much is the individual reading going to vary with respect to the mean? It will be minus 5.5. 5 minus 5.5 is minus 2.5. 6 minus 7.5 is minus 1.5. 8 minus 1.5 is 8 minus 7.5 is 1.5. Right. 10 minus 7.5 is going to be 2.5. 12 minus 7.5 is going to be how much? 4.5. Right. Guys, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is there any doubt till whatever I told?
No, sir.
Now, if I need to calculate the mean deviation about mean, then what do you think will be the formula? It will be sigma fi, where I is equal to 1 to n. See, I'm telling you the logic. If you want to calculate the average of xi, then xi should be multiplied with frequency. Xi should be multiplied with individual frequency divided by sum of all the frequencies. If I need to calculate the average of deviations, then what am I supposed to do? Then I need to multiply each deviation, each absolute deviation with whom?
X bar.
So, yes, modulus of xi minus x bar represents what? Modulus of xi minus, okay. See, I'll tell you the way the formula has actually come, okay? For mean, the formula is, you're calculating the average for what? Individual readings, no? Xi. If you multiply that xi with individual frequency and divide it with frequency and do the sum in the numerator separately and denominator separately, that is going to give you the mean. Now, what about mean deviation? You are calculating the average of deviation. So average of deviation means each deviation is xi minus x bar should be multiplied with individual frequency divided by the sum of all the frequencies where I is equal to 1 to n and the numerator also I is equal to 1 to n. Are you able to understand? This is what? This is the mean deviation about the mean. So what am I supposed to do now? I have got xi minus x bar. Is the data sufficient? What is it actually? What is it I need? Do I need xi minus x bar or modulus of it? Yes. See, my energy is getting drained. Okay. If you're able to understand, say yes. If you're not able to understand, tell me so that I'll try to explain a different way. If you're going to be silent, I'll just shut it off. And you can do a self-study of this chapter. If you think this chapter is all about form, please open your mouth and speak. I want others also to speak. What is happening? Are you clear with this? This chapter is not about form.
Explain that fi again. Like how which, by multiplying which one, which mean derivation for frequency.
For mean deviation, right?
For frequency table, sir.
This one,
No, sir. This last formula you put, right, sir?
This one. Yes, sir. You're asking how that formula has actually come, right? Is that what you're asking?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. See, again, I'll go back to the same example. Marks, students. Okay. 20 marks obtained by 5 students, 25 marks obtained by 4, whatever is the data. Okay. And I've randomly taken. So for average, what do? You will multiply this 20 with 5 and 25 with 4. Right? So you prepare, if I call this as xi, if I call this as fi, then you will have xi into fi. So 20 into 5 is going to be 100, 25 into 4 is also going to be 100. Are you clear with why we are doing xi into fi? That I've explained, because 20 you should write 5 times, 25 you should write 4 times. Instead of doing all those things, we are saving space.
Yes, I understood.
Right. So you will multiply this 200 and you will divide it with whom? Divide it with 9, you're divided with the total number of students, you will get the average of the marks of those 9 students. Okay, so that's why the formula is sigma xi fi divided by sigma fi. Now comes another question. If I have to calculate the mean deviation, before I calculate the average of deviation, I need deviation first. Right, so what is going to be, let's say this value is 21. I'm randomly taking, let's say it is 21 approximately. Okay. Then what is going to be the deviation of each reading? 20 with respect to 21 is minus 1. 25 with respect to 21 is 4. Are you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
So this is deviation. If I take the modulus of this, that is 5. Okay. If I take the modulus of it, that is 1 and 4. If I take the average of these two, what will I get? 5 divided by, that 5 should be divided with whom? Divided by the total number of students. If I do 5 by 9, am I doing the right thing?
But sir, why 9, sir?
No, not 9. I do 5 by 2.
Yes,
sir. If I do this, am I right?
Sir, you have to do 5 by 3, sir.
Why 3? How many students' data have you taken?
Sir, but we have to take deviation as the denominator, sir, while we are doing for probability.
Yeah, da, mean deviation, what am I trying to say? Mean deviation is nothing but sum of all the deviations divided by the total data you have in your hand. With respect to, forget about the left-hand part. I'm asking a question of why you are not supposed to think like this, okay? You listen to my question. If I take only the deviation column, in the deviation column, how many rows do I have? Rows means horizontal. Column means vertical. I have two data, right? The average, the sum of those two data is 5. If I divide 5 with 2, I'll get 2.5. I'm asking, is this the mean deviation for this problem? The answer is...
It is not the
mean deviation, because when you write it in the discrete form, what did it say? For example, the same problem, when you write it in the discrete form, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 25, 25, 25, 25, right? Now that frequency column will go. There is no column for, when you write in the discrete form, there is no question of frequency distribution, right? So, the average of this came out as how much? 21. Then, if I write a deviation column, then here it will be minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. 4, 4, 4, 4. Now, calculate the average of all these things. The positive values, if you take 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 4, 4, 4, 4. How much is the answer? 5 plus 16. How much is it? 5 plus 16. 21. 21 divided by 9. How much is that?
2.4. Like that, 3, 4. Like
it will be somewhere around 3, because you will have 3 as a reminder, 27. So 2.3 something. But when you took two data, you got only 2.5. So see, if you do an approximation, I can say both are close by. Why don't we take that itself? But is it technically right? Out of the two methods that I approached, which one is technically more correct?
The second one, sir.
Second one, right? So, what am I supposed to do to the deviations that I've obtained for individual readings? Here, what did we do? One is multiplied with...
To multiply with...
Now you are able to understand why frequency came.
Yes, sir. Now I understood, sir.
That is the reason why the formula is sigma of modulus of xi minus x bar into frequency divided by the total frequency. Because xi minus x bar will be for individual reading. Let's say that reading is getting repeated 10 times. You need to multiply it with 10. Because that also needs to be taken into consideration. That is the reason. This is what is mean deviation about mean.
Sir, so in the denominator, we should divide it by the total number of observations.
Not total number of observations, total frequency. Frequency because that is the total number of data you have in your hand. The meaning of frequency is how many people or how many, whatever it is. How many readings are there? So I'm repeating it again, Ra. If you write in the discrete form, if you write it in the discrete form, you will get the people who obtained 20 marks 5 times. Instead of writing the 25 times, I'm trying to write 20 here and 5 in the side. That's it. See, I'll give you a simple example. Everybody knows how to use an Excel sheet, right? You have seen it, right? You use it for some purpose. If you have an Excel sheet, let's say I'm giving you the work of entering your class marks. You will happily enter those 20 marks here. No problem about it. Right? Because in a normal screen, you will be able to see. It will be easy for you to enter and it is fine. But the same thing, instead of asking your class, if I ask you to enter the data of same 12th standard from 10 schools, will you be comfortable to do that? Because on an average, what would have happened? Let's say there is a 30 marks test that is happening. There will be range of marks, right? There might be students who have obtained 20 marks. So 20 marks would be the marks of 10 students. So instead of entering 20 in the Excel 10 times, what you will do is you will create another column called as frequency. If you write 20 here and 10 here, you're trying to tell the person that 20 marks is obtained by 10 students. That is the thing you're doing. Instead of sitting and writing, entering 20, 10 times, you're just spreading it across two columns. You're able to understand discrete data and this are the same. Only thing is different ways of notations. That is why when you deal with discrete data, you will have sum of all the values. You can do this in Excel and see. You just select all the values, it will show you the sum at the bottom.
Okay, sir.
Got it. You're able to understand why this is happening, why you need to multiply with frequency and not with the observations.
Yes, I understand.
So that is the meaning. That is the reason. To avoid the clumsy data, we do this. See, generally, this discrete frequency is used for huge data. Like when you're doing an example, you're doing for 9 and 10. This is for you to understand. But on a real-time application, that is the main reason for doing it. Okay. Suppose I ask you a question for the same frequency distribution. If I ask you to calculate the mean deviation about median, you people tell me what will be the formula. There is something similar. Put a dash, okay? Take a ratio. Denominator by default is frequency. Sigma I is equal to 1 to n. What will be the numerator? The frequency multiplied with what? Each individual reading's variation from the median and its sum. Are you able to understand? I'm not telling you the formula. I'm explaining you the logic of how to remember. Does this make sense? Got it, right? This is about median. Till now, I spoke only about mean. So this number keeps changing. Why I am saying this is because in this problem, they have asked about what? They have asked the mean deviation. Okay, not this one. Nah, this is a problem we did. No, they asked mean deviation about mean. In the next problem, they have asked the mean deviation about the median. Are you able to understand? So that time things will be different. The formula itself will be different, which I will explain in the next class.
Okay, sir.
Clear. So till here, I want you to practice and I'll give you some homework. Practice it or else you're not going to understand. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 completed before next class. In exercise 15.1, the first 6 problems have to be completed.
Okay, sir.
Do it. So that's it from my side today. We'll see you in the next class. Is there any other doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, just wait for a minute.